Hello, dear children. I am glad to see you today. Рада вас бачити сьогодні. Welcome to InterClass. Вітаю вас в інтеркласі. I am sure you are looking forward to seeing the second part of the famous Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. Я впевнена, ви з нетерпінням чекаєте продовження відомої різдвяної пісні, написаної Чарльзом Діккенсом. So you will not wait much. Enjoy the watching. Вам не потрібно довго чекати. Насолоджуйтесь переглядом.
"Spirit," said Scrooge, who felt sorry for the boy, "tell me if Tiny Tim will live." "I see an empty seat," replied the ghost, "and a crutch without an owner. If these shadows don't change in the future, the child will die." This made Scrooge very sad, but the spirit went on and took Scrooge to his nephew's house. Fred and his friends had a very cheerful party and played games. Scrooge really enjoyed their party and wanted to stay for another while. But in a second it all faded, and Scrooge and the spirit were again on their travels. Suddenly, Scrooge noticed something strange about the ghost. Two children-like figures were at the ghost's feet, a boy and a girl. But they looked old and dreadful, like little monsters. Scrooge was shocked.
"Spirit, are they your creatures?"
Scrooge asked.
"They are man's creatures," said the spirit. "The boy is ignorance. The girl is want. Beware them both, but most of all, beware this boy,"
said the spirit.
"Have they no place they can go?"
asked Scrooge.
"Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?"
The spirit turned on Scrooge with his own words. The bell struck 12. The ghost of Christmas present disappeared, and at the last stroke of the bell, Scrooge saw the third ghost coming towards him. Slowly and silently, the ghost came nearer. It was very tall and wore a deep black piece of clothing which covered its whole body and left nothing of it visible but one outstretched hand.
"Are you the ghost of Christmas yet to come?" asked Scrooge. "I fear you more than any other spirit."
The ghost did not say a word, and Scrooge was really scared. They wandered through the city, and Scrooge heard some men talking about a person who had died. Scrooge knew the men and wanted to find out whom they were talking about. But the spirit moved on. The ghost led Scrooge through the streets that were familiar to him, and as they went along, Scrooge looked here and there to find himself, but nowhere was he to be seen. They entered poor Bob Cratchit's house and found the mother and children by the fire. Quiet, very quiet. The noisy little Cratchits were as still as statues. When Bob Cratchit came in, the children hurried to greet him. Then the two young Cratchits got upon his knees and laid their little cheeks against his face as if to say,
"Don't mind it, Father. Don't be sad."
"You went there today?" said his wife.
"Yes, my dear," returned Bob. "I wish you could have gone. It would have done you good to see how green the place is. But you'll see it often, I promised him that we would walk there every Sunday." "My little, little child," cried Bob, "my little child."
He broke down in tears. He couldn't help it. If he could have helped it, he and his child would have been farther apart, perhaps, than they were. The ghost moved on and took Scrooge to a churchyard. The spirit stood among the graves and pointed down to one. Scrooge slowly went towards it, and following the ghost's finger, read upon the stone of the grave his own name, Ebenezer Scrooge.
"Spirit,"
Scrooge cried, "Hear me, I am not the man I was. I will not be the man I must have been so far. Why show me this if I am past all hope? Good spirit, I will honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year. I will live in the past, the present, and the future. The spirits of all three shall be within me. I will not ignore the lessons that they teach. Oh, tell me that I may change my fate."
Full of fear, Scrooge caught the spirit's hand. But the spirit suddenly changed. It shrunk and faded, and finally turned into a bedpost. Yes, and the bedpost was his own. The bed was his own, the room was his own. Best and happiest of all, the time before him was his own, and he could make the best of it.
"I will live in the past, the present, and the future," Scrooge repeated as he got out of bed. "I don't know what to do. I'm as happy as an angel. I don't know what day of the month it is. I don't know how long I've been among the spirits. Hello? Hello there?"
He ran to the window, opened it, and put out his head.
"What's today?"
cried Scrooge, calling downward to a boy in Sunday clothes.
"Today?" replied the boy. "Why, Christmas Day."
"It's Christmas Day," said Scrooge to himself. "I haven't missed it. The spirits have done it all in one night. Hello, my fine friend. Do you know the poulterers at the corner? And do you know whether they've sold the big turkey that was hanging up there?"
"What, the one as big as me?" returned the boy. "It's still hanging there now."
"Is it?" said Scrooge. "Go and buy it. I am in earnest. Go and buy it and come back with the man that I may give them direction where to take it. I'll give you a shilling for it. Come back with the man in less than 5 minutes, and I'll give you half a crown."
The boy was off like a shot.
"I'll send it to Bob Cratchit,"
whispered Scrooge cheerfully.
"It's twice the size of Tiny Tim."
He dressed himself in all his best, and at last got out into the streets. He had not gone far when he came towards the two gentlemen who had walked into his office the day before.
"My dear sir," said Scrooge, "how do you do? I fear I wasn't pleasant to you yesterday. Allow me to ask your pardon, and will you have the goodness to..."
Here Scrooge whispered in his ear.
"Lord bless me," cried the gentleman. "My dear Mr. Scrooge, are you serious? I don't know what to say to such generosity."
In the afternoon, he went to his nephew's house.
"Fred," said Scrooge, "it's your Uncle Scrooge. I have come to dinner. Will you let me in, Fred?"
Of course Fred let him in. It was a very hearty welcome, and they all had a wonderful party. But Scrooge was early at the office next morning. Oh, he was early there. If he could only catch Bob Cratchit coming late. And he did it. Yes, he did. Bob was a full 18 minutes and a half behind his time. Scrooge sat with his door wide open that he might see him come in.
"Hello,"
growled Scrooge in his usual way.
"What do you mean by coming here at this time of day? I am not going to stand this sort of thing any longer. And therefore," he continued, jumping from his stool, "and therefore I am about to raise your salary. A Merry Christmas, Bob."
Bob Cratchit was very surprised, and so were many people who found Scrooge so changed. Scrooge became a better person. To Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was a second father. Scrooge became as good a friend, as good a master, and as good a man as the good old city knew. Or any other good old city or town in the good old world. It was always said of Scrooge that he knew how to keep Christmas well. May that be truly said of us, and all of us. And so, as Tiny Tim would say, God bless us, everyone.
I hope you liked this story and kept in mind the moral of it. Сподіваюсь, вам сподобалась ця історія і ви закарбували у пам'яті мораль. We shouldn't blame other people for our misfortunes, and it's in our hands to live a better life in peace and harmony. Ми не повинні звинувачувати інших людей у наших нещастях. І це в наших руках жити кращим життям, в мирі та гармонії. I wish you Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Бажаю вам веселого Різдва та щасливого Нового року. And may all your dreams come true. Нехай усі ваші мрії збуваються. Take care and goodbye.
Hi everyone, this is Teen Time with InterClass. My name is Alexey and today we will talk about a city, city furniture, city streets and types of cities. So be with us, stay and don't click your channel and let's get started. You know, there are many pros of living in the city. City dwellers like there are cities, infrastructure buildings, entertainment and many other things. What is a city? Let's take a look at the following presentation. So, actually today we will talk about a city and the question is very simple. What is a city? Areas in the city are absolutely different. Actually, they are urban area. It is a whole city where city dwellers live. And of course, the area is residential. Residential area is a peculiar area where residents live. A very popular area is suburban. A suburban area is an area that is very good for environment and of course recreational area. If you look at this picture, you will see a very famous city, New York. Downtown is usually the older part of the city where many of the businesses and corporations chose to place their offices. There are different types of cities: car-friendly, bike-friendly, or just car-free cities like Venice in Italy. So, you need to know more and the following presentation will help you to do this work. Now we will take a look with you at types of cities and city streets. Actually, there are different types of city streets. They are avenue, boulevard and many others. What is the most pedestrian-friendly city? Actually, it's Venice. If you just take a look at Venice, you will see here a lot of different places. The first one is actually canals. The canals are very popular in Venice, so people can go and just relax on canals. What do you know about street furniture? People say they are invisible things that simplify life in the city for city dwellers. I think you may agree with this saying, so next presentation shows some important street furniture items, so learn it attentively. Now let's take a look at street furniture. Though in the city there are different kinds of street furniture, it looks like real furniture, but it's in the open air, so the first one is a bench, to sit and to relax. A flower bed, just to enjoy your mood. And of course, if you are in a city, you will see a trash can. It's not very good when you throw litter in the open air in the street, so you have to put it into a trash can. And finally, it's a curb. Now let's take a look with you at the following street furniture item. The first one is a street light. And of course, a traffic light. So, if you have a bike and the city is a bike-friendly one, you have a bike lane to ride a bike. It's a good quiz to check how you remember words about a city, and now we have prepared a special quiz for you. Be very right and try to give right answers. So, let's watch this presentation. And now we have to try a quiz about a city. You know much info about a city, and this quiz will help you to improve and boost your English vocabulary. So, let's get started. The first question is very simple. You have to choose three items of street furniture. Bed, flower bed, lights, or just traffic sign. If you were attentive during the program, you can say very easily, this street furniture is a flower bed, traffic lights, and a traffic sign. Next question is, a city building where you can repair your car, it's a workshop, it's a hardware shop, it's a car repair shop, or it's a market. You are right if you say that is a car repair shop. Okay, let's go on. What building belongs to public catering places? It's a cafe, or a concert hall, or actually a museum, or maybe just a theater. A public catering place is an actually place where you can eat out, so this place in this list is a cafe. Okay, you have done a lot of work about the city, you know much info, have successful English classes, enjoy your winter holidays, Merry Christmas, take care, and goodbye!